Today we are going to talk about two common misconceptions that trouble women and which are given as a fairly common reason for going in for an induction or a cesarean section. The first one is cord around the baby's neck. Many women are told that at the end of pregnancy, when the scan shows that there is a cord around the baby's neck, they are told that it's better for you to go for a C-section, or they are told that, you know what, it is your risk. If you can try for a normal labor and delivery, but the chances are that your baby may be stressed, so make a choice whether you want to have go in and try for a labor or go for a cesarean section, which puts the woman and the family in a fairly delicate position of deciding without really knowing what the averages are as far as cord around the baby's neck is concerned, as well as what are the routine outcomes that go along with that. So something that is to be understood is that one out of every three babies is born with a cord around the neck. For most babies, it doesn't bother them at all. Most of the time, the cord is long enough and the baby is able to make its way down the birth canal even during labor and handle the stresses of labor fairly well, and as long as the labor is allowed to progress at its own speed, what we find is that sometimes there might be a slightly the pushing phase might be a little longer sometimes. If the cord is very short, then the pushing phase may actually be even very fast, but somehow the body and the baby, it's a mother and mother baby, it's a delicate dance between mother and baby, and usually as long as the labor is allowed to progress at its own speed without external augmentation, induction and so on and so forth, all really putting time pressures, usually what we find is that the babies make it just fine, and the cord, even though they are born, sometimes they are born with a one time around the neck, the maximum that we have seen at our birth center is a four times cord around the neck. Sometimes they are born with a cord around the neck and around the torso. So all of these things are there, and it's just that the baby knows how to make its way out. Now, of course, you will ask that, okay, what happens if my baby gets stressed because of this cord? And certainly, I think it's one of the things that we know is that as the labor progresses, what do we do? We monitor the baby much more frequently as the stresses of labor increase. Whether or not we know if there is a cord around the neck, when the stresses of labor increase, the monitoring is a bit more frequent. So what are we monitoring? We are monitoring for the well-being of the baby, which we hear through baby's heartbeat. As long as the heartbeat is well, why should we worry about whether the baby has a cord around the neck or not? Doesn't seem to make sense. If that same cord around the neck is bothering the baby, we would hear it with lowered heart tones, or at the peak of the contraction, we might hear, especially when mom's pushing, a drop in the heartbeat, but then the baby recovers beautifully. Now, if the baby is not recovering and is not handling the stresses of labor, then we would have to say, what is the next step that we take in order to ensure the safe birth of baby? And sometimes we would find that maybe a labor is not progressing because of an extremely tight cord that the baby is being held up, but baby's heartbeat is fine. That's one possibility. The other possibility may be that the heartbeats are is not in an optimal range for long periods of time, and a decision is made to do something different with whatever intervention that are required, including perhaps a cesarean section, in order to make sure that the baby is healthy at birth. But to say that because a cord has been seen around the baby's neck during an antenatal scan, and to say that, you know, because of this, let's take a decision even before labor sets in to go in for an elective cesarean section, does not make sense whatsoever.